Candidates, okay. This will be the end of the stream. Before we finish, let's analyze a little bit the candidates. So let's go to watch live, Liren's live. So no, this is not what we must do. So broadcast. So what happened in the candidates? So I know that Giri Vaskela Graf again lost. Yes, I know. So the only game we can analyze. Okay, let's analyze some game from this tournament. I think the round we must analyze. Wait. Is the game of where we can find this game, guys? So broadcast. Let's go to the candidates. No candidates. 11 round. Wrong round. Yes. Okay, guys. For me, the most important game it was Ding Liren versus. This was the game of the tournament. Let's analyze together with Stockfish. This will be my gift for you guys, for all of you that you participated in the tournament. Yes. So exactly what Dukis is saying. So guys, let's analyze the Anish Giri. Anish Giri is a legendary chicken. He should be the president of the Psycho Chickens. Like saying, we know this. Anish Giri is a great player. And now guys, with four more rounds to go, the tournament is difficult. Three round more rounds to go, sorry. Even if Potmiatis is half a point in front of Anish Giri. I don't know what will happen in the candidates. So let's check the game of Giri versus Ding Liren. So we are here. Giri, Ding Liren, candidates, round 11. So this was the most interesting game of the tournament. E4, E5, knight f3, knight c6. This is a Spanish defense. Bishop a4, knight f6, castle. This is a Spanish defense, guys. Bishop e7, bishop takes e6. I remember this line. One of my best friends from Thessaloniki was playing. He quit chess. One of my best friends was playing this line when I was junior, and he recommended me, maybe you could play this, he told me. Actually, this is the old main line. Now, it seems that the black lost a tempo. It seems that white lost a tempo because white could immediately take on c6. White could immediately take bishop takes c6. Of course, now with the move bishop a4, there is some slightly differences. The difference is now white can gain a tempo with the castle. I don't know, knight d7, I don't believe. Queen d6, bishop d6 is the move, I think. So you see that also black lost the tempo. Knight b2. What I really liked in this game, it was the move knight a5. This move I like, this move I like, and this is the move I want to see. So knight a5 is a very good strategical move because you pressure the pawn. Here it says that white has a small advantage. Yes. And now, according to computer, the best move for Giri was the move a3. I didn't get the point of a3 to avoid the move bishop b4. For me, this is very strange, very strange. So Giri, as the grandmaster, he played queen e2, a logical move. Queen e2, bishop g4 it says, and now he played the move c3. Clearly, white plan with the knight on a4 and a5 is to push the pawns. This is white's plan, and to try to attack the weak king on c8. I think this is my personal idea. So he played c5, a3, c6. Good reply by Ding Liren, so that he can have this. So he played b4, bishop c7. Until this moment, white played great. I think that white played a great game. According to computer, the best move for white was knight c4. But who will blame Giri for developing his bishop on e3. Now, knight c4, for me, this, you know, guys, when you follow the game with the computer, who would play here knight c4? I mean, Anish Giri played the best move, the most logical move, which is develop the piece and attack the pawn on c4. But computer, according to computer, for unknown reason for me, the move knight c4 seems to be the move. For me, this is crazy. For me, this is crazy. To lose a tempo, I don't know. So, bishop e3. Sorry. So, he played here, excuse me. So in this kind of moment, he played the move bishop e3. Nice. Ah, sorry, what he did? Sorry. Ah, he played knight b3. Yes, knight b3 is a chicken move. Okay. Yes, knight c4 looks good. Yes, but he played knight b3. No, this seems to be a bad move. But from the other hand, okay, let's go to the mind of Anish Giri. Why he played knight b3? Why he played knight b3? Ah, to pressure the c4 pawn. And computer said that it was better to play knight c4 if you want to move the knight. Okay, and if you play again the same knight d7, to go a3, a4, and attack with b5. Now, this is very nice chess. I really like what computer is saying. This is a beautiful idea, knight c4. So knight c4 was the exclamation mark. This was the move. So knight b3 was a mistake. It seems a mistake. He played knight d7, ding Liren, h3, good move, bishop h5, bishop e3, very logical move. And now, according to Giri, Giri was shocked with the move f5 in the game. Yes, now Giri lost the control of the position, so he took on c5. And now let's see what happened in this position. And here I think that Ding Liren, this was the critical position. This was the critical moment. I think he should have played queen f7. He played queen f7, rook b1 to defend the knight. And I think that here Ding Liren pressured too much. This was the critical moment of the game. I think he should have simply taken e4. Simplicity is the best in chess, guys. F takes e4, I believe this was the move. F takes e4, F takes e4 seems to be the chess move. And after queen takes e4, Anish Giri, the analysis, said that he was afraid of this. He said that only white could be worse in this position. But okay, according to computer, he said that in this position he was fighting for a draw. This is what he said in the analysis room, if I remember well. But according to computer, after queen takes e4, it says h6 simply. Nice move. Perhaps white has a pawn now, but see the pair of bishop. See the weak king on it, and no, we will suffer in the diagonal. We will suffer in the diagonal. So this was a great opportunity for him. g5, even g5 said it was good. Okay, he took an f5. g4 is double question mark. So queen f5 was the move for him. And now what should Giri play? Of course g4 doesn't exist. This move doesn't exist in chess. Because of course you can take bishop takes g4. And I don't analyze. And that's king h1, e4. One dax, okay. If you believe in chess. If you are a chess player. And for that reason, after queen takes f5, after queen takes f5, I think that Anish Giri, because he's a very solid player, he will play queen e4. This was the critical moment. Black is okay. Of course, black is okay. Black is okay. But he decided to go for g4. Now g4 is a blunder. I think Liren is not in a good shape. I realize this, I'm saying this, guys, because I follow the game with Vaskela Graf. Ding Liren was completely winning and he missed many opportunities to win and he made the draw. And also today, guys, this move g4, this, I think this is an awful blunder. Because knight g5, queen takes f4, h4, great move by Anish Giri. And now white is better. White just have a pawn up, he played b6. And now what is really beautiful, the move knight e4. This is a chicken sacrifice. I will call it a chicken sacrifice. This move is all the money. Yes. No, I haven't played Ding, I don't play this kind of things. So, but after knight e4, guys, strategical sacrifice of a piece. You know, this is a chicken sacrifice. This is exactly a chicken sacrifice. I was very proud for Giri for doing this. This is a chicken sacrifice because you have two pawns for the piece. The pawn on a6 is weak, so you can pressure it with the queen. And, okay, so you can play d4. And if you don't like, maybe the knight, you can bring the knight to c4. Or, even better, maybe you can bruise the queen to b2. I don't know, many ideas for white. So Ding Liren played knight f6, but what else he could play? I don't know, knight b8 I was thinking personally, but okay, if you have 2800, you don't play this kind of moves. According to computer, queen b2 was the move. I will never play queen b2 in my life. But computer says queen b2, I trust queen b2. And after king d7, it says simplicity knight bd2, here, queen b7, threatening the bishop, rook d7, most probably, and queen a7, I think, with the play strategy rook b7, yes, queen b2. My question, will you play queen b2, even a grandmaster? Okay, let's ask my friend who is here in the chat, will you play queen b2 here? I think it's difficult move queen b2. Personally, guys, I would play knight d2. Personally, I was considering the move knight d2. Personally, I was thinking the move knight d2, but according to computer, knight d2 is not so good because of g3. Okay, this I can calculate as grandmaster, and after f3, bishop g6, and who is the boss? Black is the boss, it says. Logically, because black can have counterattack. And for that reason, you must play queen b2. So after g3, you avoid all the counterattack with f takes g3, open the file, 3 pawns for the piece, no, it's enough. So queen b2. Queen b2 is a great move. Queen b2 is a very solid move. And why not knight d6? Let's check this. Bishop d6, c d6. This is what I will consider a knight c5. If I play bullet, I will play immediately knight c5 with the idea rook takes b8 or queen b2. Even this, according to computer, maybe knight d7, and says the computer the position is not equal. But how to continue? Okay, knight d6. Wait. Okay, queen b2 is winning. But knight d6, bishop d6, d6, rook d6. Queen e3 and all that. Never. I will never play in my life queen e3. Queen e3. Now, guys, if you look at the computer says queen e3, queen a7. Okay, that's. Who would play here queen e3 on earth? Nobody. No, nobody. This is very difficult. But queen b2 was the winning move for him. So after knight b8, queen b2 was the move. So he played knight f6, which was a mistake. And now knight d6. Now that the knight is not on b8, the a6 pawn is unprotected. So bishop d6, cd6, rook takes d6, and the fork d4. Of course, d4. Guys, we play 2 hours bullet. You can understand the point of b4. So c5, it says double question mark, but already the position is plus 3. No, white is winning. White has a crucial, white has a huge attack. The only point is this move, but queen takes a6, king d8. I don't believe in this move. In this position, whatever white is playing is winning. White can play so many moves. Rook fe1, knight c5, knight takes d4, so many moves. So many moves are winning for white, and for all these reasons, he played c5. He played c5, which was a mistake, knight takes c5. Now, white has 3 pawns for the piece, 2 pawns for the piece, sorry, but queen c4 is coming, and queen b4, or queen b2. With the idea of b8, so rook d8 only move, and here in this moment he resigned. I think he resigned in this moment, yes, he resigned. I think this is too much. White is threatening many things like knight e4, knight b7, knight c6, only move king d8, but after king d8 I can sit here, king b7, take the bishop. No, this is enough. This is more than enough. All the moves are winning for white, d takes e5, for example, or rook b6. And for all of these reasons, he resigned. So this was the game from the candidates. Congratulations to Giri. Giri made a big victory today. I think it was very important for the rest of the tournament. 3 rounds to go. Of course, Nepomniachtchi still is first with half a point difference. I think he has 7 out of 11, 6 and a half out of 11 is Giri, and of course 6 out of 11 is Fabiano Caruana. These guys will fight for the candidates. Who will be playing with Carson? We will very soon find out. In 1 week we will know. Αυτά από μένα, guys. Thank you everybody for watching. This was the stream of the day. Thank you very much. I will go to make a raid. Before we close, I will put you some chicken song, guys. Thank you everybody for being here with me, guys. Thank you for participating in the tournament. Ευχαριστώ πολύ. To all my students, thank you for playing in the tournament, guys. We will make many surprises.